folder tracks. I'll talk about them in a little bit about track templates locating. But anyway, so when I launch Pro Tools, I have it set so the dashboard is what it shows. And for instance, these are my session templates that I've created. My naming convention is bit depth and sample rate. So this one is 2448. This is a guitar vocal with virtual instruments. So I'll click on that, because what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create folder tracks. Yeah, so I'll name this folder dem. Okay, so this is how my sessions launch that I've created. What I have here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 folder tracks and their associated audio or MIDI tracks. The way it opens is typically the folder that I have open is the one that I'm going to probably record first. So most of the time I record either the acoustic rhythm guitar first, or sometimes I'll record acoustic rhythm guitar and a lead vocal all at the same time. Okay, so folder tracks. Obviously, one of the main aspects of folder tracks is you can collapse them or open them at will just by clicking these little folder icons. Now, something that kind of distinguishes, and I think Pro Tools does this automatically, is face of the channel strip is grayed out. And then I have it set up so all my other associated tracks, my audio tracks or my MIDI tracks, are colored in the entire channel strip. So that makes it really easy. No matter what I have open or closed, I instantly know where my folder tracks are, because there are these gray-faced ones. So that's really great, I think. Anyway, so back to what's going on. So this is how it opens up. And the beauty of a template, of course, is all I have to do is select it from the dashboard, launch it, and then the only thing left to do to record is record arm that, record on my transport bar, and I'm ready to roll within seconds, literally. In creating folders, when you're either setting up a template or if you need to add additional folders to a session for some reason or other, so I'm going to do that. So what I'm going to do is go up to Tracks, New. Let's say I'm going to create a set of drum tracks. So I'm going to do 4 mono instrument tracks, and I'm going to do 2 stereo instrument tracks that I might want for my hi-hats or room mics, whatever. Okay, so all I have to do is hit create, so that's all normal. Getting these into a folder, it's really simple. You could either obviously go up here to new track and then select a track, and I use routing folders, not basic folders. That's a different workflow, and I don't use it, so I can't speak to that. Anyway, I use routing folders. So you could do all that, or much quicker is you can simply right click on the tracks, go to move to new folder, and then if it isn't already coming up, and it is for me because I always just use routing folders, and then also make sure this route tracks to new folder is clicked for my workflow. And what that will do is any tracks that are highlighted, it will include inside the folder and route it to it. So then I just need to name this drums and hit create, and there it is. There's my folder track. Okay, and as you can see, they're all routed to drums, so it automatically creates a bus named drums, makes that the input for the folder track. The only auxiliary tracks I have are this parallel reverb track, my N7 track, and then this main sub bus 2-mix track, or 2-bus as it's often called. So this is for my hardware reverb that I use, and then with my hardware compressor on it. Okay. So I've created these, they're routed to the drums, and then I color coordinate everything. So I like brown for drums. So boom, we're ready to go. And then, so I'll just put these over here. That's how easy it is to create them. So now what I'll do, if I want to make this into a session template, I simply go up here, choose Save as Template, name it. I pre-made a folder inside where session templates reside. And so it's now that's going to be in Kev's templates.